Happy morning, my dear children. Now we are discussing about the organic chemistry, am I right? The last class we learned about that, the preparation of phenol, am I right? Preparation of phenol means from Dow's process, how will you prepare phenol? From sulfuric acid, benzene sulfuric acid, how will you prepare phenol? And also cumin. Okay, cumin, how will you prepare phenol? That is the industrial preparation, etc. Am I right? Today, our learning objective is to learn about the chemical properties of phenol. What are the properties? What are the chemical properties of phenol? This is one of an indirect question. Sometimes the question will be asked about that. How is benzene prepared? Or explain Scout and Bowman reaction. How is aniline prepared? Write the chemical properties of phenol. Like that, there are many questions coming. So, there are chemical properties, there have many lot of indirect questions. So, try to understand the question, okay? Here the first one is, from phenol or reacts with zinc. What happens? Phenol reacts with zinc. We get benzene and also zinc oxide. That's the first chemical properties. Second property, what happens? Ammonia reacts with the phenol. What happens? Ammonia reacts with the phenol. We get aniline. Okay, ammonia reacts with the phenol, we get aniline. Next question is about that. The preparation of ester, for example, phenyl ethanoate, phenyl benzoate, phenyl acetate. This is another question. How is phenyl ethanoate prepared? How is phenyl acetate prepared? How is phenyl benzoate prepared? This is another question. So we have to write the equation. Phenol reacts with acetyl chloride to form phenyl ethanoate. Phenol reacts with benzyl chloride to form phenyl benzoate. One of the, this is about the ester group. Ester group means, we learn that one, that is COO group, that is called ester group. Next one is the next chemical properties, the preparation of ether. Ether function products more that one ether, that is O, right? Oxygen, we are saying that ether. Here, how is ether prepared? That is by Williamson ether synthesis reaction. Okay. And about that, oxidation reactions and also having the reduction reaction. Phenol undergoes oxidation, we get 1,4 paraquinone, para-hydroxyquinone, like that. Sorry, 1,4 paraquinone. Next about that, phenol reacts with hydrogen in the presence of nickel at the temperature is about 160 degrees Celsius. We get cyclohexanol. These are some chemical properties. Okay. So, each one properties we have on the equation. For the examination point of view, we should be write the equation thoroughly. Then only we can be score full mark. Okay. Please all of you take the equation, we can be write the equation. All of you take the note.
What are the chemical properties of phenol? Today, this is our learning objectives. Before, already we learned that what are the preparation of phenol. Am I right? From chlorobenzene, how will you prepare the phenol? And also from benzene sulfonic acid, how will you prepare the phenol? From aniline, how will you prepare the phenol? And from cumin, how will you prepare the phenol? These four preparation over. After that, we have some properties. Okay, that means we have to discuss about the chemical properties of phenol. What are the chemical properties of phenol? Okay. First one, reaction with zinc dust. Okay, for the first one is reaction with zinc dust. First of all, we are taking phenol. I told you that the formula for phenol is C6H5OH. Okay, for that, C6H5 and try one of the benzene ring.
Okay, benzene ring, OH. Now, the name of the compound is phenol. This one reacts with the zinc. You can be say heating. Okay, this one heated with zinc. Okay, here the zinc all combines with oxygen. Zinc combines with oxygen. We get zinc oxide and the hydrogen will be attached to this carbon. Okay, the hydrogen is attached to the carbon. So we get benzene. Plus zinc oxide. Here, first we should be write the structure of phenol. Structure of phenol. Then about you should be write the symbol of zinc. Anyhow, the phenol on heated with zinc, we get zinc oxide. Zinc on combines with oxygen to form zinc oxide, and also the hydrogen will be attached to the carbon, so we get the benzene. So what is the formula for benzene? C6H6. Where the second one is about the reaction with ammonia. Reaction with ammonia. So, what is the formula for ammonia? NH3. NH3 is the formula for ammonia. Okay. You have to write the structure of phenol. This is a phenol. This one reacts with ammonia. Here we are using one of the reagent that is called anhydrous single chloride. The formula for single chloride is ZnCl2, single chloride. We are heating. Here, the OH and combines with one of the hydrogen from ammonia. Clear? The OH and combines with one of the hydrogen from ammonia. We get water. So the NH3 group is converted into NH2. Okay? NH2, am I right? So hydrogen, here having one hydrogen, combines with the OH to form water. So the NH3 is converted into NH2. The name of the compound is aniline. Clear? Can you learn the two equations? What is the first one? That is phenol on reacts with zinc in the presence of heating. We are heating here. So the zinc on combines with oxygen. We get zinc oxide and also we get benzene. So from phenol we can be prepared benzene. Clear? From phenol we can prepare benzene. Okay. Next about the second one is reaction with ammonia. So don't forget to learn about the formula for ammonia is NH3. The phenol, all of you know that one, C6H5OH. So NH3. Here, one of the hydrogen combines with the phenol OH. We get water molecule in the presence of anhydrous single chloride. So, the main major product is aniline. Don't forget to learn the formula for aniline. That is C6H5NH2. What is the formula for aniline? C6H5NH2. Next, one of the very important naming reaction. That is about the Schouten-Baumann reaction.
What is the purpose of this reaction? Is for the formation of ester group. Okay, the formation of ester. We can say the preparation of ester. Okay, the Skouten-Baumann reaction. Here, phenol on reacts with acetyl chloride. Okay, what is the formula for phenol? C6H5OH. What is the formula for acetyl chloride? CH3COCH3. Here in the presence of one of the alkali, okay, we get phenyl acetate. We have to write the question. Formation of esters. Okay, that is Skouten-Baumann reaction. Skouten-Baumann reaction. Here we are taking phenol. What is the formula for phenol? C6H5OH phenol. This phenol on react with acetyl chloride. The previous we learned about the carboxylic acid. That is one of the examples is acetic acid. What is the formula for acetic acid? CH3COCH3. Am I right? Sorry, CH3COOH, acetic acid. Formula for acetic acid is CH3COOH. Anyhow, from the CH3COOH, the OH is replacement by adding Cl. Am I right? This is the formula for acetic acid, CH3COOH. What is this one? Acetic acid. Okay, the formula for acetic acid. I am replacing OH and adding Cl. So the name of the carbon is acetyl chloride. Okay, acetyl chloride in the presence of NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide and also pyridine, that is POI, we get phenyl acetate. We get what? Phenyl acetate. Okay. Of the hydrogen combines with Cl. So what's the product? Here, the hydrogen combines with the Cl to form HCl. So, what are the qualities obtained? Z6H5OCOCH3. There, otherwise we can be right. C6H5COOCH3. Okay, so COOCH3 or start with here CH3COOC6H5 phenyl acetate. Name of the compound is what? Phenyl acetate. Phenyl acetate. Yeah. This is about the Skouten-Baumann reaction. What is about the Skouten-Baumann reaction? The preparation for esters, the formation of esters. Okay? That is phenol reacts with acetyl chloride formula CH3COCl. We get phenyl acetate. Okay? We can be write one more product here. We shall use about the benzyl chloride, okay? Phenol formula Z6H5OH phenol. Phenol reacts with benzoyl chloride. C6H5COCl. Okay, for writing the benzoyl chloride, what is the formula for benzoic acid? That is C6H5COOH. Am I right? This is the formula for benzoic acid, the replacement of OH, and we are adding Cl. So the formula is C6H5COCl, benzoic chloride. Okay. Anyhow, in the presence of sodium hydroxide, okay, sodium hydroxide, here the hydrogen combines with Cl. The hydrogen combines with Cl to form hydrochloric acid. What is the remaining body? C6H5COOC6H5. Here, C6H5COOC6H5. Okay, the name of the compound is phenyl benzoate. Okay. And also the hydrogen combines with the Cl to form HCl. Hydrogen combines with Cl to form HCl. Can you write this equation?
Already I told you about the benzoyl Schouten-Bergmann reaction. By the reaction between phenol and acetyl chloride. We get C6H5COOCH3. Okay, phenyl acetate. That is also Schouten-Bergmann reaction. Here we are using phenol with benzyl chloride. We get phenyl benzoate. Okay, this is also Schouten-Bergmann reaction. Anyhow, we get the compound COO.
There also we get C6H5COOCH3, phenyl acetate. The COO, that is called what? Ester. Okay, ester group. It's very important. Try to learn this question. Anyhow, the next one is about that the formation of ether. Here, ester means COO is an ester. Ether means simply we have to write O. The functional group is O for ether, and ester is COO. Don't forget that. Formation of ethers. One of the scientists' name is called Williamson synthesis. Williamson ether synthesis. Okay, this is also one of the important question. How is ether prepared? That we can say about that. How is anisole? Anisole prepared. One of the new term. We have to add here about that one of the new term, that is anisole. Okay, new formula, anisole. Yesterday we learned that one of the benzene ring, this is called what? Toluene. Am I right? Toluene. Otherwise toluene. Here anisole. Yes, children, can you differentiate the both new compounds?
The first compound is about the toluene and second compound is about the anisole. What are the differences between both the two? The first compound having no oxygen, only CH3. Benzene with CH3, that is about the toluene. And the second compound is benzene with oxygen and also CH3. That is about the anisole. So the oxygen group is called what? Ether group. Okay, anyhow, try to understand this concept.
Okay, so how will you prepare anisole? Can you say what is the IUPAC name of this carbon? IUPAC name. IUPAC name. Number of carbon is 1, am I right? Number of the carbon is 1. So the alkyl name is meth, am I right? Whatever. Meth. Okay? Meth. Clear? The functional group O, the suffix, the secondary suffix O, am I right? You should be heard the name is about an oxy. O means you should be right. Oxy. Meth oxy. Okay. This carbon is about what? Benzene. Methoxybenzene. Methoxybenzene is the IUPAC name of anisole. Methoxybenzene. Okay, what is the common name? Anisole. Clear? Have a doubt?
No doubt. Okay. Shall we do the preparation of anisole? It's also one of the important questions.
Dear children, what is the name of this compound? Phenol. Okay. Yesterday we learned that phenol on reacts with sodium hydroxide. Am I right? Phenol on reacts with sodium hydroxide. Okay. The hydrogen combines with OH. The hydrogen combines with OH. We get water. So the Na molecule, Na atom will be attached to oxygen. The Na atom is attached to oxygen. So what is the name of the compound? O-N-A. O-N-A. Okay? Here water is living. Okay. So the name of the compound is sodium phenoxide. What is the name of the compound? Sodium phenoxide. So, what is the formula of sodium phenoxide? Sodium phenoxide. C6H5ONa. C6H5ONa. This is the formula for sodium phenoxide. So, anyhow, the first one, phenol on reacts with the sodium hydroxide. From the sodium hydroxide, one of the hydroxyl group, that is OH group, will be attached to the phenol hydrogen group. So hydrogen combines with the OH to form water molecule. Here the Na will be attached to the oxygen. So we get this oxygen with the sodium, we get sodium phenoxide. Okay, don't forget that. The name is sodium phenoxide. The formula is C6H5ONa, sodium phenoxide. Sodium phenoxide. Clear? The sodium phenoxide again on reacts with methyl iodide. Methyl iodide. It's on heating. Okay. So I'm heating with methyl iodide. Can you say what is the formula for methyl iodide? Methyl iodide, methyl. Can you say methyl formula? CH3, very good, CH3. Methyl with iodine, you get CH3I, methyl iodide. So, this sodium combines with iodine, you get sodium iodide. This sodium combines with iodine, we get sodium iodide, that is NaI. So the CH3 group is attached to oxygen. CH3 group is attached to oxygen, am I right? We get sodium iodide. Sodium iodide. Clear? So, what is the name of the compound?
Anisole. Okay, what is the name of the compound? Anisole. So, what is the functional group of this compound? Oxygen. So, we can be say ether. Okay, ether. One more compound we can be say. We are replacing the methyl group and adding ethyl group. We get phenetol. Okay, don't forget that. That is phenetol. Okay. This is about anisole.
Anisole. Okay. So, which are the areas are over? One about that. First one. Benzene. Okay. Reaction. Preparation of benzene from phenol. Phenol reacts with zinc. We get benzene. Okay. Second one is about the formation of ammonia. So, reaction with ammonia, we get the formation of aniline. So, phenol on reacts with ammonia in the presence of anhydrous zinc chloride. Anhydrous zinc chloride. We get aniline. Phenol formula what? C6H5OH and also with ammonia. What's the third one? Formation of ester. Formation of ester. Here we are using what? Ester group. When formation of ester means phenol with acetyl chloride. What is the formula for acetyl chloride? CH3COCl. Acetyl chloride. First we have to write the formula for acetic acid. CH3COOH. The OH is replaced by adding Cl. So we get CH3COCl. Acetyl chloride. We get phenyl acetate. Okay, phenyl acetate. Arabic, as per the IUPAC name, phenyl ethonate. Okay, as per the IUPAC name, phenyl ethonate. Anyhow, next one is about phenol reacts with benzyl chloride. What's the formula for benzyl chloride? C6H5COCl. How will you get benzyl chloride? By the reaction between benzyl acid. What's the formula for benzyl acid?
C6H5COOH. COOH. Benzyl acid. The benzyl acid, we are replacing the OH. We are adding Cl. Benzyl chloride.
Okay. So, on the reaction between benzyl chloride and phenol, we get phenyl benzyl. Last one is about that. The formation of ether, one of the very important question. Preparation of anisole. How will you prepare anisole? By Williamson synthesis. How will you prepare anisole? By Williamson synthesis. That is, phenol reacts with sodium hydroxide. We get sodium phenoxide, which are further heated with methyl iodide. We get anisole. It's a very important question. Try to learn this one. Anyhow, two more equations valid for the chemical properties of phenol. The next one is about the oxidation reaction and also the reduction reaction. Okay, oxidation. Here, phenol undergoes oxidation with the air or acidified potassium dichromate and with concentrated sulfuric acid. We get benzoquinone, benzoquinone. Okay, very important question. Okay, one of the oxidizing agent. Okay, phenol. What is the formula for phenol? What is the formula for phenol? The phenol. This phenol. We shall be using the bond. Okay. This phenol on reacts and undergoes oxidation with potassium dichromate. The previous video, many times I told you about that. Potassium permanganate formula and also potassium dichromate formula. Am I right? What is the formula for potassium dichromate? K2Cr2O7. Okay, don't forget that. Acidified potassium dichromate. That is K2Cr2O7. Okay. And concentrated sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay, you have to oxidation reaction. We are adding oxidation. Okay, anyhow, from the para position, yesterday I told you about the position. Am I right? The nearest to the functional group is called ortho. Ortho, the second one is about the meta, and the opposite is about the para. Am I right? ortho, meta, and para. Am I right? So from the para position, the hydrogen, this hydrogen, hydrogen combines with oxygen, we get what? Water molecules. H2O, water molecules. Okay. So this oxygen will be attached here. So what is the product here? Oxygen, oxygen. Okay. Here is a bond is changing, am I right? So here we have double bond, then single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond. Okay. Here we have carbon balance is 4. Don't forget that. We have what is the name of the compound? Okay. There is number. We have to see the number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 4. Benzoquinone. Okay. Benzoquinone. Can you write the equation? It's an important question. One of the oxidation reaction about the phenol. Phenol undergoes oxidation with acidified potassium dichromate. What is the formula for potassium dichromate? K2Cr2O7. K2Cr2O7. Already we learned in the fourth lesson, am I right? Formula for potassium dichromate. And also we learned about the preparation of potassium dichromate. It's a very easy question. Okay. Anyhow, potassium dichromate formula K2Cr2O7. Okay, and on oxidation here, hydrogen combines with the oxygen to form water molecules. So we have to write water molecules. So the oxygen will be attached here. So we get 1, 4 benzoquinone. Okay, and also we have one more equation about the reduction. Reduction reaction. Okay, that is phenol. What is the formula for phenol? C6H5O, okay, phenol. On catalytic hydrogenation, that means we are adding hydrogen molecule, okay, plus the presence of nickel. We are using one of the catalysts is called nickel at 160 degrees Celsius. What's the temperature? 160 degrees Celsius. So here hydrogen will be attached. Hydrogen will be attached to each place. Okay. 1 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 3 hydrogen, 4 hydrogen, 5 hydrogen, 6 hydrogen. Total how much hydrogen is there? 6 hydrogen. Sorry, 3H2. Okay. So when you are writing on the product side, we should be replace the bond. Okay. So we should be replace the bond. Okay. What's the name of the compound? Cyclohexanol. Cyclohexanol. Okay. So these are the chemical reactions. Chemical reactions of phenol. Try to understand the concept. So from the chemical reaction, there is chemical properties. Which are the products are formed? That is the question. The first one is about that preparation of benzene. Am I right? What is about that? Preparation of benzene. That is about the first preparation. Second one is preparation of aniline. The third one is about that preparation of ester. We can give the Schouten-Baumann reaction. Okay, Schouten-Baumann reaction. Okay, next one is about the ether group. That is about the aniso. anisole. The fifth one is about the preparation of 1,4 benzoquinone. Third one is cyclohexanol. Listen, my dear children, for the chemical properties of phenol, we get the following products. Which are the following products? That also you try to understand. Okay. From phenol, when we adding zinc dust, don't forget that zinc dust, that is symbol of zinc is easier, and I'm right. So we get benzene. Okay. We get benzene. That is the first one. Second one about the aniline. So here the function could be CNH2. So by the reaction between ammonia, phenol on reacts with ammonia. Don't forget that ammonia. This formula is ammonia. We get aniline. Next about the Schouten and Bowman reaction. It is for the preparation of ester group. What is the functional group here? COO, ester. Don't forget. For the Schouten and Bowman, ester group COO. For we are using phenol with acetyl chloride and phenol with benzyl chloride. Okay, with the one of the catalyst we are using here, sodium hydroxide. Okay, we get phenyl benzoate and phenyl ethanoate or phenyl acetate. Okay, that is about the Schouten Bowman reaction. Next one is the preparation of anisole. That is the about the ether. We are saying about the ether. That is about Williamson synthesis. Williamson ether synthesis. Here we are using phenol with sodium hydroxide. Here water is removed. Am I right? Water is removed. We get sodium phenoxide. We get what? Sodium phenoxide. So the sodium phenoxide, and also we are adding methyl iodide. What is the formula for methyl iodide? CH3I methyl iodide. We get anisole. Anisole and sodium iodide. The next one is about the preparation of 1,4 benzoquinone. That is the reaction between phenol with oxidation of acidified potassium dichromate and concentrated sulfuric acid. We get 1,4 benzoquinone. This is also important question. Next about the last one. Preparation of cyclohexanol. That is phenol on reactive with hydrogen in the presence of nickel at the temperature is 160 degrees Celsius. We get cyclohexanol. Okay. Dear children, these are the chemical properties of phenol. Try to learn at least 3 equations. The first one is about the preparation of aniline, the reaction with ammonia. That is about the preparation of aniline. Reaction ammonia, formation of ester, formation of ether. Okay, this is one of the Navier reaction. Formation of ester is one of the Navier reaction. Please, we have an indirect question. These are the indirect question. Try to understand. Sometimes it may be asked by the preparation like that. Okay, anyhow, you should be thorough the concept. Okay, here I wrote here formation of ester, that is Schouten Bowman reaction. Don't forget that Schouten Bowman reaction, ester group. Next one is the formation of ether, means Williamson synthesis. Okay, preparation of anisole. Okay. These are the questions I am giving the assignment. Please all of you try to write the assignment. Okay. Thank you all of you. Thank you. Have a nice day.